Please choose your skill level. Welcome to the age of the great guilds.
Signa, it is the dawn of your 17th year. The elders await you in the sanctuary.
I've never known them to weave such a bright messenger, nymph. I wonder why the elders want to see me. I'd better get down to the village.
The last leaf of autumn. It's dawn. There's the long tapestry. I don't remember it looking so old and frayed. The threads describe the creation of the world and the passing of the two shadows. Here's more of the tapestry. The pattern shows the entire history of the weavers, back to the founding of the great guilds. The last section tells about the decline of the guilds. There's a third shadow gathering. That's strange. The end is completely torn off. There's Hetchel. And the elders don't look at all pleased with her.
You have heard the findings of this council, Dame Hetchel? Have you anything to say in your own defense?
My elders. My actions speak for themselves.
This reckless defiance is intolerable. Any secret you share with Signa's son might be turned against us.
His talent is awakening, and the power is very strong in him. We dare not desert him now.
Stubborn old fool! Who are you to decide such things?
Enough, Lachesis! Hetchel, I'm grieved to see your many years of service end in such disgrace.
My destiny is yours to weave.
Hetchel, the fabric of your life has been woven by your own choices.
Gaze once more upon the great loom, if you would know your ultimate destiny. For that destiny is now upon you.
swan's egg. What does it mean?
Something is deeply wrong. That draft has never failed before.
What is that noise? Outside!
The guild is under attack!
Who dares to desecrate the great loom of the weavers?
This is the work of that demon boy! We should kill him while we still can!
Your name will be cursed forever! Son of Signa! Loom Child! Bobbin Threat!
My name? But I had nothing to do with this! Wait! Where are you going? No explanations. No goodbyes. And once again, I'm left behind.
It's heavier than it looks. Those are the same four threads spun by the elders. They're still echoing in the loom. Egg, it's trying to open.
There's my boy.
What's happening? The whole village has flown away without us.
From the moment you came into this world, Bobbin, great and terrible things have been happening. The elders hoped that your birth was the cause of it.
Why would the elders want to get rid of me? I'm such an awful weaver that they never even let me study with the others.
They fear you, Bobbin. When the swan arrived, they were already trying to weave the same draft on you that they had worked on me. But the draft turned against them. It means only one thing, that the pattern is failing of its own accord.
No! Can't it be stopped?
Stop chaos? The only thing to do is embrace it and turn ourselves into creatures of shadow, or plan our escape.
Escape? To where?
I don't know. But if we are to survive, we must find out where that flock has flown and join them if we can. You've already found Atropos's distaff. Good. You won't be able to weave very much with it at first, but as you practice, its true power will be revealed to you. It's time to leave this island, Loom Child. Your destiny lies beyond the sunset, across the sea.
Mother Hetchel, where are you going?
Goodbye, Bobbin. I must follow the swans.
Well, this is a fine mess. Everybody's gone and I still don't understand what's going on. Why did they keep calling me Loom Child? Nobody's ever let me anywhere near a loom. I can't read it. The owl's tail feathers are covering the words.
Ouch!
Destiny shall draw the lightning down from heaven, roll its thunder far across the sea, to where I wait upon the shore of wonder, on the day the sky is opened and the tree is split asunder.
The day the sky is opened. There's an owl in there. Another owl. Didn't know there were so many owls in these woods. All the holes are full now. There's an owl in there. Don't these people ever clean up after themselves? Don't these people ever clean up after themselves? Maybe I should stand a bit closer. It might help to point at something first. I've already spun all that. It's still dripping, what a mess. That's the Book of Patterns. I already know what's in it. I already know what's in it. grass green. I hate that color. This wall hasn't been dyed yet. This wall hasn't been dyed yet. Grass green. I hate that color. Grass green. I hate that color. The color changed. Looks much better in white. Looks much better in white. This wall hasn't been dyed yet. I guess that isn't a draw. Ugh! Green again! There. Looks much better in white. Looks much better in white.
Is it over? I think that's close enough. What's going on up there?
Welcome to Crystal Guard, stranger. I'm Master Goodmode, 31st in the Noble Guild of Glassmakers. And who might you be?
My name is Bobbin. Bobbin Threadbare of the, Noble Guild of Weavers.
A weaver! Tell me, is it true that to peer beneath a weevil's hood brings instant agonizing death?
I honestly don't know. Nobody's ever tried it with me. You have such a wonderful view of the sky here. Have you noticed a flock of swans flying this way?
Swans?
Swans. You know, birds.
Yes, yes, swans! No, I haven't heard of any swan sightings. Look around to your heart's content, Weaver Threadbare. And remember, if you break it, you buy it. Near this spot, Lucian Bottleblow, founder of the Noble Guild of Glassmakers, attained his final clarity.
Softshard, wife of loosened bottle blow, here attain final clarity.
That's beautiful. I've never seen anything sparkle like that. Not even the long tapestry. What kind of glass is it?
It was carved from a single crystal of diamond.
But I thought you were glassmakers.
No, we are. A dear boy, this is none other than the famous Cro-Max conundrum wrought by our distinguished founder, Lucent Bottleblow. His works once filled an entire museum, you know. And that was before the great dragon arrived in 7342. She blew through this city like a torch, melting and breaking our finest works, plundering our museums and treasuries until we had almost nothing left. It was awful, just terrible, really a miserable time. Even Bottleblow's greatest masterpiece, the first scrying sphere, was lost forever.
But you still have the conundrum.
And a lucky thing, too. It was on loan to the Guild of Vintners at the time. It is the sole remaining example of our founder's transcendent genius.
But I'm still curious. Why is it diamond instead of glass?
We've no idea. No idea at all. That's the conundrum, you see.
Huh. A glass bell. I wonder what will happen if... I'm dizzy. I can barely hear what they're saying.
I trust Your Excellency is pleased with our progress?
That all depends on how far this sphere can help me see.
4 hours, most assuredly. Perhaps 6, with a bit of luck.
Only 6 hours? But I expressly requested 8.
Every sphere is unique, Bishop. It is impossible to accurately predict how well this sphere will perform.
I need at least 8 hours. 8 hours, Master Crucible! See to it!
Look!
Who are you, lad?
And just what do you think you're doing up here?
I'm not sure. I just rang the bell and
Well, I'm sorry, but you're not supposed to be here.
Step back under the lens, please.
This is a restricted area. No visitors allowed.
Good day, sir.
I guess I'm not supposed to go up there.
Halt! Who goes?
Well, well, well. Looks like a scrawny runt trying to sneak into our flocks.
Sneak? You call that sneaking? I heard them coming all the way in from town.
Thought you were going to fleece some shepherds, did you? Maybe we ought to take the shears to you instead.
Listen, I mean, I'm not looking for sheep or trouble. I'm looking for a flock of swans.
Swans?
Swans. You know, birds.
Oh, swans, of course.
We should have known. Everybody comes here when they want swans.
Next you'll be telling us you're some sort of wizard off to fly away with them birds.
Right.
Wizard? Wizard? You wouldn't happen to be the great wizard that Fleece was telling us about, would you now?
Fleece?
He is sort of dressed like a wizard.
I don't know. He doesn't look very powerful to me.
Me neither. I say we don't let him by until we know for sure. Come on then, wizard. Let's see some magic. Or else...
Come on, lads. He's had enough. Let him go.
Some kind of wizard, eh?
Don't trip on your robe, little wizard.
Get on, you lazy bunch of yous. Back to work.
Doesn't seem to affect them at all. I wonder, did it work? Only one way to find out.
Our esteemed Bishop Mandible cuts quite a figure, doesn't he?
I don't doubt the Crucible's getting tired of bowing and scraping to him. Why would the clerics want a scrying sphere anyway? I thought they didn't believe in the future.
Yeah, your guess is as lucid as mine, Flute. But Crucible appears to think that they're up to no good again.
Then why would he do business with them at all? Let alone sell them a sphere.
Well, you know Crucible. He'd sell his own mother's spectacles if he thought there was a profit in it. And the clerics are paying off in cash.
Which should keep us in the clear for years to come. Still, I'm certainly pleased that Crucible's not taking any chances. This scythe might become very useful if our friend the bishop has been less than transparent with us.
Ouch!
Yes. Very useful indeed.
That scythe is even sharper than a weaver's spindle. That scythe is even sharper than a weaver's spindle.
He's back!
So are we.
It's the dragon!
Well, that worked. Funny, I don't feel very scary.
You! Get away from here!
Now I've got to go and round them all up again. And you'd better not be here when I get back. Go on now.
Hello there.
Who said that?
I did. My name is Fleece, first chosen of the Guild of Shepherds. I wish we had time to chat a while and trade some tales, but we have got a serious problem on our hands.
What sort of trouble are you having?
It seems we've a dragon nearby who has an enormous appetite for fresh mutton. We breed our sheep for extra whiteness, so we cannot keep them on the meadows. She can spot them miles away. By now, the dragon has carried off so many that we may not be able to fill the cleric's order.
The clerics? I just saw the bishop at the glassmaker's.
Bishop Mandible? He placed the order for 10,000 sheep.
10,000 sheep? That's enough to feed an army.
Yes, that had occurred to us too. You noticed our increased patrol in the forest. We'll deliver the sheep to the clerics if we can, but we won't trust them.
I suppose fighting the dragon will be out of the question.
Only a mage can save us. I see you've noticed my little friend.
She doesn't look at all well.
She isn't, and my songs of healing don't seem to be bringing her much comfort. I wish I were better with him.
Her eyes opened, just a little. Try it again.
The flock is out to pasture. You'll find them there. Go forth, wizard, and may you return safely to our fold.
Maybe I should stand a bit closer.
Well, what have we here? Oh, that's what comes of being in such a blazing hurry, I guess. I thought you looked a bit scrawny. Why, you'd hardly make a decent kindling.
That's, quite a bit of gold you have there.
That? Oh, that's nothing compared to what it used to be. Piled floor to ceiling it was. Everyone said it was the most beautiful lair anywhere, and right they were, too. Then one day, last spring it was, comes along this third-rate wizard who botched up everything. He tried to get the volcano to blow, but only shook up the place in a huge earthquake instead. Broke all my fancy glass, mind you, and made off with most of the gold, too. The only thing he left me was a gorgeous glass ball. Have you no manners, lad? Stop staring at me.
Oh, was I staring? So sorry.
Oh, don't mind me, love. I get rather crotchety on an empty stomach.
Does that mean you're going to incinerate me, then?
Incinerate you? Oh my, aren't you the foxy one? I haven't created any fire since my last mating season, and you don't want to know how many centuries ago that was. No, that's much too much heat for me these days.
You mean you can't breathe fire?
Can't? Let's just say I won't. Just between you and me, love, the stuff gives me the heebie-jeebies. Put it back the way you found it, now.
I guess that isn't a draft.
Sheep. Gold. Sheep.
It might help to point at something first. Guess I won't be going back that way. My own reflection. Bishop Mandible. What in the world is he up to? Spheres work well enough without drafts, remember? Repair costs must be spiraling. These grave markers are forged from solid bronze.
Hello there. What's that? Your music woke me up.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, not to worry. I'm Rusty. Rusty Nailbender.
I'm Bobbin Threadbare, of the Weavers.
Weavers, eh? Our folk are blacksmiths. I'm supposed to be getting firewood for the master, but this plateau's been picked cleaner than a new blade. Come over here. That's us down there. The forge. That's what we call it. I've heard you weavers don't get out much. What's your business here?
I've been looking for a flock of swans.
Swans? No. No swans around here. Oh, say,
All this talk has made me sleepy. A real pleasure, though. Oh, let me know if you find your swans. Oh.
He's fast asleep.
Hello, young nailbender. About time you were coming home. Stoke's been looking for you, and he ain't real happy. You better get in there right now.